Hello and welcome to this Haas tip of the day. Running more than one part at a time might be the easiest way for us to increase our productivity. In today's tip, we're going to show how we program from multiple parts, and we'll also touch on why this skill is so important for your shop. Everything for me begins with my setup sheet. So check this out. I've got a block loaded up. After tightening up those tools by hand, here I've got one lonely vise on my machine table. My demo part here takes 6 minutes to run. This part uses more than a dozen tools. So of that 6 minute cycle time, about a minute and a half of it is spent doing tool changes. That is our chip to chip time, with the coolant starting and stopping on this particular machine. Now each time a part is done, I will open the doors, grab my handle, open the vise, put the handle away, remove the part, pick up the air gun, blow off the part, return the air gun, load a new part, pick up the vise handle, tighten my part, return the vise handle, close the doors, and press cycle start. So it is taking me about 7 minutes per part total, not counting inspection, for each part. A big slice of my time per part is spent on tool changes and swapping the part out. This is time spent making money, and this is, well, there's room for improvement. Now, if I have 250 of these parts to run, it's gonna take me about 30 hours or 4 shifts of my time. Now, I can go ahead and build an amazing fixture, or I can find every vise that I can and load up the table. If that happens, I can run 10, 20, 30 parts all at once with one push of the green button. We are still spending about a minute and a half doing tool changes, but that time is spread across dozens of parts instead of a single part. When we spread those tool changes across an entire table full of parts, that slice of the pie almost doesn't matter. We've gone from a minute and a half per part down to just a few seconds. So why do we want to run multiple parts? It minimizes the number of tool changes. Another essential reason for running multiple parts is that we save time just swapping those parts out. Instead of me having to open and close those doors dozens of times, we now open them just once. Instead of us having to pick up that vise handle dozens of times, we do it just once. Instead of pressing the cycle start button dozens of times, once for each part, we now just press the green button once for each batch of parts. My part changeover time, which was taking a minute or longer per part, is now taking 30 seconds or less, because we have reduced the number of times we need to open doors, pick things up, and press that green button. It gets even better though. When I was running just one part at a time, I couldn't really leave the machine much. The cycle time was just too short. Extending our unattended run time is just another reason to run multiple parts. In our scenario, running dozens of parts at once, our machine can run unattended for hours at a time. This means that I can be running two machines at once, or I can be programming the next part while these parts run. This means that my machine can be running through my lunch break when it might otherwise be sitting. If I time things right, I can have the machine loaded with stock and ready to run as I walk out the door. This is gonna give me an extra couple hours of cycle time each and every day. This is production. This is getting it done. Now we've sold you on why you should be running multiple parts, but how do we actually accomplish this? We're gonna do this on our control using an M97 local subroutine call. Now, your control already has this built in, and you can be using it right now, and we're gonna show you how. On Haas machines, subprograms come in two basic types, M97 internal subs and M98 external subs. With the M97 internal subprogram, all of our subprograms are stored in a single file along with our main program. This makes keeping track of things really simple. You load a single program and you run it. With an M98 external sub call, each of your sub programs, each of your operations, is stored in its own O number program, which means you might end up with dozens of programs to manage. This is a file management nightmare, which is why I prefer to use an M97 over an M98 whenever possible. A simple M97 program consists of a main program and one or more local sub-programs. Our main program is everything between our program's first line, the O number line, and the M30 program stop. We'll put our local subprograms after our M30. Our M97 local subprogram is everything between a certain N line number and an M99 return call. Now watch me single block through this program. With each press, another line of code is executed. G154P1 is just another work offset call, like G54 or G55. These are our expanded work offsets, and we'll use one for each part. Now, when I run this M97P100 line, it is going to jump to local sub N100, an N number that corresponds, matches, our M97P value. The control will run through whatever code is in our sub until it reaches an M99. When the M99 is run, we return from our subprogram back to our main program. In this program, if we keep going, we'll reach our M30 and the program will stop. Now that we know how an M97 works, here is how we use it to run multiple parts. We're going to start with a simple proof program written for a single vice. We need to take the code for each tool and separate it into subs, subprograms. We'll place our subs after the M30. Now, some CAM systems can actually do all of this for us automatically. These subs must not have work offset calls in them, so those can be removed. These subs must start with a unique N number and end with an M99 return. Once a local subprogram is created for each tool or tool path, we can add in our M97 calls to our main program. If we run through this example program, we're gonna call work offset G154P1, which is the work offset for our first part, and then we are going to call our N100 subprogram, which contains the tool path for tool one in this example. Then we call our G154P1 again and call our M97P200 local subprogram, which brings us to sub N200 in our program. Each time an M99 is reached in our sub, we return to the line just after the M97 sub call. With all of our subprograms written, it's easy to add more parts. We just add more work offset calls and more M97 subprogram calls. We've loaded up a second vice onto our table, and we're calling this part G154P2. G154P1, G154P2. Now, in the code, we'll call up our work offset G154P1, which is our first vice. That first tool is going to come in and run M97P100. Then we'll call up our second work offset, G154P2, and we'll call that same subroutine again. We'll then come up and do a tool change. We'll call up G154P1 again. We'll call up our second subroutine, M97P200, which will run tool 2 on this first part. Then call up our G154P2 second work offset, and we'll call that same sub again, M97P200. Now we can just keep adding work offsets or vices until we've filled up our entire table. Well, there's one last thing that we have to take care of here in our code. Take a look at this. You can see that all of our vices are at different heights. They're not even close to being even here. So this is a dangerous situation. So we're gonna have to adjust our Z clearance at the end of each one of our subroutines. We're gonna change my Z.1 clearance plane to a Z4.0. This is gonna have the tool coming up 4 inches above our parts before it moves from part to part or from vice to vice. This is just something we add in for safety. Well, we've shown you how and we've shown you why. So the next time you have lots of parts to run, grab your calculator and do some quick math. Decide if it's worth it for you to spend the time to add more vices to your table. Or maybe it's time to build a dedicated fixture, or maybe even a subplate that can be held with clamps or put on your table with a vacuum fixture. Remember, it's not how fast you can finish that first part that matters. It's how fast you can finish that last part that really counts. Well, that is it for M97. Thanks for letting us be a part of your success and for watching this Haas Tip of the Day.